Hey, my name is Steve. I'm a docent on the USS Midway, and we are in a room, a special room, right off the hangar deck of the USS Midway. And my friend over here is Mr. Univac, and he's going to help us explain all these special things about language, codes, ciphers, and a shorthand called ASCII code. So let's start basically by talking about the computer and how the computer is able to talk back to us. So first of all, the computer uses something we call binary language. Binary language meaning two, a one and a zero in this case, or a zero and a one. You see this white square right here? This white square has magnets. If the magnets are arranged one way, it creates a one. If they're arranged the other way, it creates a zero. And so the machine is able to process eight numbers like that. But that's complicated. That's really complicated. Couldn't we shorten it in some way? I think we can. There's something called the American Standard Code for Information Exchange. All right? That's called ASCII. And ASCII says you can do the eight numbers in just three, like 039 or 069. So that's an ASCII code, and that's how we end up today coding computers. Okay? So this computer speaks in that special language. Now, a code, when we talk about a code, that's a fixed relationship between some letter or number or symbol and another symbol. Sounds pretty simple, all right? Let's take it a step further. You all use emojis, all right? That's a code, right? You have a happy face, you have a sad face. Also, slang. Somebody's a dude, a homie. That's the same thing. So that's a code, all right? So this computer processes information. And if it gets information from another part of this room, an area that we refer to as a gyroscope, that information is processed in here in what we call an interface. And that interface, all it does is convert language into something the computer can use, okay? The whole purpose of this room is to set up and give us navigation information, latitude and longitude. Latitude and longitude using information that's developed from a gyroscope processed over here by our friend Mr. Univac. Now, let's apply that more practically to something which we're talking about, message traffic, all right? Some message traffic is pretty easily readable, all right, in plain language. But we start coding it and breaking it into different blocks, it becomes more difficult to read. And that relationship, mixing things up, is called a cipher. Cipher. And a cipher is used to scramble a code so that it's unreadable. And then we make it more difficult. We put it into blocks of five letters or five numbers, and that creates a message of different groups of blocks. So that's called a cipher, all right? So what cryptologists and cryptographic people do is help encode messages, and then if they receive a message that is from somebody else, some other location, they help decrypt it using certain rules in certain language itself. So that's the sum total of what happens in this room. Computer language, binary, ones and zeros, put into a shorthand called ASCII code, three numbers, okay? And there are different numbers for uppercase and lowercase in the English language. And then that information is processed through a computer interface, and that interface shows up here as lines of navigation equipment. But if we go down to the Midway's communication system, now we're talking about messages that actually read something other than navigation information. We're talking about things that are really important, like where the Midway is, where we're going to go next, plans, really, really important stuff that we don't want anybody else to read. So this is Steve, a Midway docent, and I encourage you to come on down to Midway. Come into this very special room just off the hangar deck, which has so many neat stories about binary language, codes, ciphers, cryptography. It's all patterned right in here. So come on down and visit us, please.